Welcome to Shane's Weekend Builds. Today I show you how I built this router table extension with a micro slot for the Fusion 3 Laguna table saw European version. And I try this one in English because I think most of the people that are interested in US style table saws are not German, because Germans all buy panel saws. No offense, by the way. I start with this offcut of a 21mm film coated plywood. First I have to cut it to width of roughly 400mm and then a length of 790mm to match the depth of the table saw and mounting options. I apply a 20 degrees chamfer on the short edges to match the shape of the cast iron table. I utilize my tenon jig to handle the sheet in upright position. Next, I set the fence to 50mm to cut the two cleats that will function as the mounting brackets to the fence rails. I found another piece of 50mm coated ply in the scrap woods that I could use to make the aprons out of. These shall also contribute to more rigidity and to pull the router table flat. I ripped them down and then cut them to lengths over at the miter saw. I decided to assemble the frame with pocket hole joinery. Quickly check the fit. I went for routing out the shape of the router plate with a flush trim bit, therefore I need to make some guide pieces. I used the router plate as a template for the lengths to set the stop block on the miter saw. Here I determined the center roughly, and then I glued the pieces to the table with double-sided tape. As you can see, I was a bit over-enthusiastic with cutting the guide pieces. It would have been sufficient to cut two of them and leave the other two in full length. My router plate has rounded edges with a radius of 17.5mm, hence I used a 35mm Forstner bit to cut the matching radius in the corners. This also serves as a starting hole for the routing process. The router plate is 10mm shy, so I use a 10mm drill bit as a gauge for the depth stop on the router. For the flush trim bit bearing to engage with the guides, I had to do a full depth in one cut. So next time a guide bushing would be the better option. Here I'm drilling the starting hole for the jigsaw. Here comes the test fit and it fits. I used the router plate as board template to drill the holes to mount the plate in place. Next, I installed my 6-inch dado stack to cut the groove for the miter channel. I didn't set it to a specific width, as I had to do two passes anyway. I made a 5/8-inch outer washer on my metal lathe because the stock washer comes recessed for 30mm saw blade bores, which are common in Europe. To set the depth, I simply took the miter channel and aligned the height of the dado stack accordingly. Then I took some measurements, did some very complex math, and finally set the rib fence to 40mm. Quickly cut the dados. Next, I took an offcut to set the rib fence to the exact width of the plywood. Then I cut two more shallow grooves on both short ends. This will make some space for the hardware, as the T-slot in the fence rail is very close to the top. Without this groove, I wouldn't be able to fit the washers and nuts. To mount the plate to the frame,
I went to town with a lot of holes to be sure everything will be sturdy. Quickly countersunk everything. And then aligned it, clamped it, pre-drilled it and screwed it together. For the final assembly, I clamped two more or less straight boards to the table saw surface in order to hold the table extension in place. This helps a lot for aligning and marking the holes to drill. Here I use my straight edge to align the height of the tables. Next, I mounted the router plate to my Triton router, placed it in its final position, and screwed the plate in place. Everything fits, miter slides, here we go. Thanks for watching.